Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. This is my first video of radar engineering video lecture series. Here I'll give you introduction to radar system where you can observe outlines of this video. Here I'll be discussing about basics, working, advantages, limitations and applications of radar system. Let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of radar system. First of all, you need to understand what is the full form of radar. See, radar means radio detection and ranging. Radio means here we will be transmitting radio waves with the use of radar system. With radio wave, here radar operates at gigahertz of frequency. So here radar system will be transmitting radio waves with the use of antenna. And after transmitting radio waves, we will be detecting object. Detection of object, that is been done with the identification of range of object. So here what we will be doing is we will be transmitting radio waves in the space, and based on reflected signal from the object, we will be identifying range of the object, right? So radar, that we use it to identify unknown object. With the use of radar, we can identify these parameters. We can identify the range of object. We can identify the direction of object, as well as we can identify the velocity of object. In short, one can say we can track the object. Range means what is the distance of object with respect to radar system. Direction means in three dimension, we can identify angles in which direction objects are there, as well as based on received signal frequency, we can identify velocity of given object. Velocity identification, that can be done with the use of Doppler's effect, that even I'll be explaining you in future coming videos. But first of all, one should know with the use of radar system, one can identify range, direction, and velocity of object. Here, radar system, that one can use it to identify unknown vehicles, tanks, aircrafts, ships, and guided missiles. First of all, I'll give you a brief idea about how radar system is operating. Here you can observe we have radar system that is having antenna. This antenna is connected with transmitter and receiver system. With the use of transmitter, we will be transmitting radio waves over here in the space. By red color, you can observe radio waves are propagating in space. It is going in this direction. Here, we have unknown target, or you can say unknown object. From unknown object, radio signal that is getting reflected over here. So reflected signal that is shown by green color over here. So based on transmitted signal and received signal over here at this system, radar can identify range, direction and velocity. Here, whenever radar is transmitting signal, at that time, that signal is traveling with the velocity of light velocity. That is 3 × 10⁸. So here, that signal that is propagating from system to object, and then signal again gets reflected back to system again. So signal is traveled by x plus x means 2x distance. And based on velocity and time, one can identify distance of the object. Here, direction of object that is been identified based on direction of antenna over here, and velocity of object that one can calculate based on frequency drift in between transmitted signal and received signal. Now, let us talk about working of radar. See, radar is trans-receiver system. So, with radar, we have transmitter and receiver. Transmitter is used to transmit high power signal. That signal will be propagating on space. Whatever object that is there in space, that will be reflecting signal back, and that reflected signal again will come back to same radar system, And based on transmitted and received signal, radar will identify location of object, right? So radar is transceiver system. Radar will be transmitting high power EM wave in space. Here, transmitted signal will be having very high power. And once that signal reaches to target, there will be reflection of signal. That reflected signal that will again come to radar system, and that signal will be very weak, right? And based on that low power reflected signal received by radar, it will be identifying target. Based on reflected signal from target object, following parameters of object can be identified: distance of object, direction of object, and velocity of object, right? Here you can observe, see, radar is transmitting signal that is shown by green color. That signal is having very high power. Here I have mentioned power is there in terms of kilowatts, but that could be there in terms of megawatts even. Here from object, signal is getting reflected. That signal that is shown by green color that you can observe, that is again coming back to this radar system. That signal is having power in terms of 10 to the power minus 12. So receiver of radar should be very sensitive, where radar is receiving signal in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 volt, but transmitted signal that is having very high power, right? And based on transmitted and received signal, radar will be identifying distance of object, direction of object, and velocity of object, right? Now let us talk about advantages of radar system. See, radar can identify objects through darkness, haze, fog, rain, and snow. Normally humans cannot see those objects in these situations. So in any weather condition, radar can identify objects, right? See, radar can penetrate through insulators even. So even if object is having insulators, then also radar can identify the situation of object, right? Radar can identify stationary objects as well as moving objects. Movable objects that also can be identified by radar based on frequency drift, means velocity of object that can be calculated based on frequency drift as per Doppler's effect, that we will be going to study in future coming video. But one should know, radar can identify stationary objects as well as objects in motion, right? Now let us discuss about limitations of radar. See, radar cannot identify the details like human eyes in close distance. Usually for short distance, for short range, radar cannot have that much details about object. Usually we use radar for objects identification with some distance, like up to 20 kilometer, up to 50 kilometer. There are different categories of radar system available that is having well-defined range, right? So for that range distance only, we are using radar. For short range distance, radar cannot identify much more details, right? Radar cannot identify the color of the target. See, here color identification that cannot be done by radar, right? Radar cannot identify the targets underwater. Underwater also radar doesn't function. Usually underwater we use sonar system, right? Radar that has been used for space identification. In space, we identify objects with the use of radar, right? Radar cannot identify the targets placed behind conducting sheet. The reason is, with the use of radar system, we will be transmitting EM waves, right? So if objects are there behind conducting sheet, then those objects cannot be identified by radar. The reason is, conducting sheets that will be reflecting signals. So if objects are there behind conducting sheets, at that time for radar it is difficult to track, right? So these are the limitations of radar system. Now let us talk about applications. See, there are many applications like military applications, but obviously in war situation we use radar system to identify military tanks, We can identify vehicles of enemies, right? There are many military applications. In air traffic control also, we use radar system. In space also, we use radar system to identify objects. In aviation, we use radar system. And in the remote sensing, to identify weather data, we also use radar system. So there are many applications with the radar system. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.